Hi, this is Mel Sole from the Mel Sole Golf School at Polly's Plantation, and this is your October 2014 golf tip. And this is a request from not a past student, but a Facebook follower of mine. I have a Facebook follower by the name of Dieter Langenecker, and Dieter has been following me and is an avid watcher of my videos, and he recently did a favor for me, and so I emailed him and said, Dieter, what can I do back to thank you for doing this? And he came back at me and he said, Mel, I have a real hard time getting my body to do what I know that I need to do. In other words, he's saying he knows where he wants to get the positions of the club. He knows the good positions, but he has a hard time doing it. Well, Dieter, welcome to the club. Everybody struggles with that. But I can give you some advice, and to all of you that are watching the video, on how to shortcut that slightly. There's no real magic wand, but if you understand that you get to your swing through the conscious mind to the subconscious mind. So all your habits in your swing are stored in your subconscious. And so when you step up to the ball is the trigger to that subconscious and will make you do whatever it is you do in your swing. If you want to change it, just going and hitting golf balls and consciously thinking about the change is not gonna work. Because the subconscious is so powerful that even though you might be thinking one thing, your body will do something else. And that's the subject today, is how to change that. And you have to do it through the conscious. You learned your swing consciously when you were a beginner. You had to consciously think about it, and then slowly that went into the subconscious. So if you want to change what's in the subconscious, you have to work via the conscious. So when you're working on your swing, so let's say for example, you have a backswing that's too much on the inside and you lay the club off and you'd love to get the club more up on plane. So when you go to hit the ball, the body, even though you're thinking of trying to get the club here, the body will get the club there. So this is the way to do it. It's a practice routine that I teach at the golf school, and all my students will know what a 48 ball drill is. And if you do the 48 ball drill, then you can make the change. If you want to know what the 48 ball drill is, come to the golf school and I'll teach you. So what I'd like you to do is do your practice swing, and you want to do it in a step-by-step mode. So I would get my students to take the club to where the correct position is and hold it there and allow the body to feel that position. From there, go to the top of the backswing, allow the body to feel that, and then swing through. Do it a second time. One, and you've got plenty of time here to look and see if the club's a little bit behind, you can correct it and allow the body to feel that position there and through. Now you're going to go to the ball and you're going to do exactly the same thing. You've got to do it step by step. So you're going to put the ball there. One, and again, you can feel that position. Two, three. Didn't go very far. I'm hitting a 7-iron here that must probably went about 120 yards. But at this point, I'm not trying for distance. So what you would do is you would practice like that. So if I show you from behind, it would be one. If you get the club a little bit behind here, you can come back, get that feeling of one, two, and then three. And then do the same thing with the ball there. You've got to have those one or two practice swings in between each ball just to tell the body. It's like a dress rehearsal before a play. If the dress rehearsal goes bad, the play is not going to be great on opening night. So your practice swing must be you telling your body, I want you to go here, then I want you to go here, then I want you to go here. And you've got to do it slowly. And then when you hit the ball, you do it in that. Once you hit 3-4 shots in that mode, then you go to the full swing mode. Try and blend it now. Try and get it all in one nice blended sequence. So now we're going to go still slowly in a nice smooth way. I'm keeping the club in the same positions. Now I go to the ball, do it nice and slow. When you practice, if you practice like that, you're working through the conscious mind to the subconscious mind. Now, this is not an overnight thing. If you want to do this, if you want to change your swing, you want to improve, do this. It takes usually between a month to 6 weeks to get through to the subconscious and change in the subconscious what you're doing. If you work on that, you can change your golf swing.